Alright, so video cut out on me, and I went ahead and just got this down to our final stage where we're about ready to notch. I might do a little more touch up and just sharpening and even out the symmetry a little bit off camera, but let's go ahead and punch in some notches here. This is my buffalo rib splinter. It's just a piece of buffalo rib split in half. I'll show you how I do my notching here. Very important to prep this tool, keep it very touched up. You don't want any hangers, and you just want a nice, smooth, consistent surface. Type to call it, maybe like an afton or something, but I'm kind of going to come in just above this base at an angle, so it might end up looking more like a dovetail or something, but we'll see. What I'm going to do first is just take a little nip, nothing crazy. Just push in and down, go ahead and get us started here. Do the same on the other side. Now it's already got a natural crook out of it here, so I'm going to kind of use that to my advantage. Okay, so that's it, just to get started. Now, the thing to do is when I set this tool up in here, as we all know with antler, you actually want some grip to it. So you don't want to, clearly you don't want to stall your notch, but a lot of people have a tendency to start flaking just as if you were pressure flaking, but actually what you need to do is set your tool up a little higher and actually roll it up on that surface and push straight down. Remember the chamfering flake from earlier, we're just trying to push down, we're not really trying to send anything super far in there. That's how you end up crushing platforms and stuff. And I'll show you how I do that later. Here I'm just scrunching a little bit, and then I'm gonna go ahead and get some inward pressure, make sure I've got that bite, and then rock up and just push down. Doesn't take much. See how that clamshelled out? It naturally will just do that. For whatever reason, when you're notching, I think because there's enough isolation. You shouldn't really have to. That would kind of double bit out, but you can see the nice little clamshell flake it's taken. Maybe, maybe not. Far so good. Just keep. Now once you've got a deep clamshell that comes out like that, take your tool and just nip the edges. Kind of go left and then right, and it builds you a little center spot in the middle of your notch channel. Do this other one here. Mosquitoes are getting me so hot today. It's finally cooling off. Fortunately, that just crushed on me. We'll see if I can recover from that. Usually, I'm gonna have to widen it out, but you know what? Probably my tool there. That's definitely what it was. Let's see if we can recover from that. It took some dancing around, but I got around it. It's a trick that only comes with much fighting. You just kind of have to take tiny little flakes and zigzag your way back into the stall, but it always requires widening a little bit. Hold on one second. Okay, we're still rolling. Nervous about the tools this whole time. Sorry, I'm gonna waste so much of this video grinding an antler or a buffalo rib. Clamshell. I think we'll call that done. You know what? Because I saw it earlier, and I know it's gonna bother me when I post it on the video and whatnot, I'm gonna straighten out this tip for you guys, just for you. On YouTube, there. That's much better. Point. Don't know what it is. Y'all tell me. Let's go get it wet. Let's go see what it looks like. That's some pretty rock. That might be like a kirk or something. I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comments. It's nice and short, that's for sure. Alright, y'all. Thanks for watching. Really appreciate it. And good luck in your Abbo flint napping endeavors.